Hello, this is Drifter, and this is another episode of This Gun Fucking Sucks. Sorry, it's actually Modern Warfare 3 in depth, and this is the CM901 episode. The CM901 is my least favorite assault rifle in Modern Warfare 3, and I happen to believe that it is the statistically weakest assault rifle in this game. Despite my own very strong personal biases, I'm going to try very hard to bring you the best and most analytical review possible. Well, first things first, with the CM901, it is a very high damage assault rifle. It deals 49 damage up close and 25 at a distance. This is tied with AK-47 for the highest damage among fully automatic assault rifles. The MK-14 and Type 95 outclass it a little bit, but those aren't fully automatic. You can't spray with those. What this means for you guys in terms of shots to kill is that the CM901 can kill an enemy in 3 shots up close, 4 at a distance, 2 headshots up close, or 3 at a distance, kind of like the ACR and some of the other assault rifles, though it does very, very much so outclass the low damage assault rifles. The first and most crippling weakness of the CM901 is its very low rate of fire of 606 rounds per minute. This is the slowest firing fully automatic assault rifle in Modern Warfare 3. It is a little bit better than the MK14 if you're able to go ham with your trigger finger, but it's really, really slow. This is more in line with like a lot of the light machine guns. What this does to your time to kill is gives this weapon the slowest overall time to kill. One of the good things about the CM901, which we're going to see in a little bit, is that it does have excellent range. So there is a distance right there in medium range during the damage drop slope where your time to kill competes with other assault rifles, but in close range, it's awful. Medium range, it's closer to normal, and long range, it's awful again, so I would say this is the slowest time to kill of any assault rifles in Modern Warfare 3. Now, this weapon does have a pretty good damage drop profile. The damage drop starts at 20 meters, however, it doesn't end until 48 meters, giving it one of the highest ranges of the assault rifles. When you factor in that very high initial damage of 49 and relatively low drop-off damage of 25, your overall profile over range is going to be very high damage. To counterbalance this is the fact that the CM901 is a high recoil assault rifle. It might not be the highest recoil like the FAD or some of the other guns, but it is definitely in the higher bunch. I would not classify this as an accuracy rifle. I have difficulty using it at long range, and if you do plan on using this at medium or long range, it's recommended that you shoot in burst because it does have a very unusual wobble to it that is very difficult to master. While nothing special, the iron sights on this gun are decent and are definitely usable. You'll see a fair number of players using extended mag or a silencer and foregoing any optical attachment, but I still prefer an optical attachment for this weapon. The reload times are a little bit on the slow side. They're definitely not fast. You know, that's a little bit of an exaggeration. That's my bias pouring through. The reload time's pretty normal. It reloads in about 2.5 seconds if you've got bullets in the magazine or not. And your reload cancel time is about 1.50 seconds or 1500 milliseconds, which is pretty normal. The other three big statistics are the same as other assault rifles. Your run speed is 90%. Your aim down sights time is 0.30 seconds or 300 milliseconds. And your aim down sight zoom, at least when you're using iron sights, is 1.35x. Now, compared to all the other assault rifles that you've seen me review, this is the statistically weakest assault rifle in Modern Warfare 3, mostly when it comes to time to kill. It's only even competitive at medium range, and the recoil tends to negate that because it's not very accurate. If this were a very accurate assault rifle and had a low rate of fire, that wouldn't be as bad. But with the CM901, you really are going to miss a couple of your shots due to random wobble, whereas people using more accurate and faster firing weapons will not, and they will destroy you. So this is the statistically weakest assault rifle in Modern Warfare 3. One of the only benefits that it has is it has a pretty good range and damage drop profile, so if you're using it in hardcore, you might get a fair number of one-shot kills, but even still, I would personally prefer to go with a faster firing weapon. My recommended setup for the CM901 plays to its strengths. It already has great range, so let's not nerf that with a silencer. Let's put a red dot sight on it so that the iron sights aren't a problem and that you can very clearly see people at range and control the recoil better. I would also recommend kick because one of its major weaknesses is the somewhat difficult recoil. Kick is going to mitigate that and allow you to shoot more accurately over range, miss less shots, and try and maximize that benefit of this being a decent weapon at medium range. Well guys, that's all for this episode. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something useful. In the next episode, I'm going to be reviewing the Type 95 assault rifle. And I'm not only going to be reviewing the Type 95, but I'm also going to be doing a little spill at the end about why this weapon is overpowered and how we could better balance it to make it a more competitive and sane weapon. Drifter out.